Good morning, everybody. Myself, Sunil Pawa, New Catholic Mission High Secondary School, Jhabua, welcomes you back for the new session of 10th class science subject. Okay, as you know that in our previous video, we already finished the electricity and its effect. So now in this video, chapter number 13, we are going to discuss about the magnetic effect of the electric current. Okay. I think so, you all are well aware and knows about the magnet, clear? In your day-to-day life, so many times you come in contact with the magnetic substances, okay? Sometime I hope so that you played with the toys of magnetic material and this one, no? And you are familiar with this one, okay? So, I just want to give an introduction of the magnet. So, what is the magnet? It is an object that attracts objects made of iron, cobalt or nickel, okay? So, I think so these two material or the substances, cobalt and nickel, is the new for your dictionary, that is, okay? Because I think so till today you just know that the magnet is used to attract only the iron, okay? But this cobalt and nickel is also shows the magnetic property. And they are also attracted by the magnet, clear? And the magnet composed to the raised in north south direction and when suspended freely, okay? Suppose that if you are taking a bar magnet, okay, and if you tie up a thread in the middle of this something and you suspended it freely, then if it is not influenced by any other magnetic field, okay, then surely when it will comes to a halt, then it will stay in the north and south direction, clear? This is the basic fact and this is the basic feature of the magnet, clear? Now, in day-to-day life, if you observe the uses of the magnets, then it basically used in the refrigerators, in radio and stereo speakers, okay, in audio and video cassette players, okay, then in children's toys and on hard disk and the floppies of the computers, okay? That means these magnetic substances are quite useful in our day-to-day life, right? Now, if we want to discuss the properties of the magnet, then a freely suspended magnet always point toward the north and south direction. As I told you, if you suspend a bar magnet freely, okay, then always it will stand in the north and south direction, right? Then the pole of a magnet which point toward the north direction is called north pole or the north seeking, clear? While the pole of the magnet which point toward the south direction is called the south pole or the south seeking, right? Now, then like poles of magnets repel each other, and while the unlike poles of the magnets always attract each other, you know that. Just like that in the electricity, we learn that the two charges will repel, similar charges will repel and the opposite charges will attract. In the same manner, these magnets are also having the repulsion between the same poles and attraction in the opposite poles, clear? Now, this Oersted, okay, the name of a scientist, he showed that the electricity and the magnetism are the related to each other, and his research letter used in the radio, television and also this one thing. Right, and the unit of the magnetic field of strength or the magnetic strength is actually named on the Oersted, that is called as Oersted unit, clear? So he basically responsible to establish a relationship between the magnetism and electricity, okay? So here we are trying to learn this fact. See that this diagram is given about the experiment which performed by the Oersted, okay? What he did, he just arrange a circuit, okay, in which this is the source of electricity, a battery having the positive and negative terminal. This positive terminal is connected with a key, unidirectional key. It has a resistor and it passes through a conductor, okay. It is made up of the aluminium, copper or aluminium here, okay, from the X to Y, and again it connected with the terminal, negative terminal of the battery. Then surely what will be the direction of the flow of current, that is from the X to Y, okay? And this is the good conductor of electricity, that is a copper wire, okay? So what happened? When we insert the plug in the key, Okay, then this circuit become closed in nature and it allowed to pass the electric current through this conductor from x to y direction. Clear? So when it just passes through x to y, then you can see that this compass, which is kept close to it, it will give a particular direction of the pole on the basis of the magnetic pole which generated on the in this conductor. Okay, now do the next thing. Just switch off the circuit, that means plug off. Okay, and then just change the terminal of the circuit. Okay, then what you will observe that now the direction of the electric current will also change. On the place of flowing from x to y, it will now move from y to x direction. Clear? And when the direction will change, which direction? The flow of electric current. Okay, then you may observe that this compass will also change the direction of the magnetic field. Okay, so finally we can conclude that whenever the current will flow through the conductor, then a magnetic field will develop and it will depends on the direction of the electric current. Okay, so this is the basic fact which we concluded by this Oersted experiment. Clear? Now then here we are going to discuss the magnetic field. Clear? So what is the magnetic field? It is the region surrounding a magnet in which the force of magnet can be detected. Okay, and it is a vector quantity having both the direction and the magnitude. Clear? So what is the magnetic field? Whenever you will place a magnet, okay, in an open area, then uniformly in all direction it is responsible for influencing the magnetic substances up to a certain area or the certain distance. Clear? So the distance or the area which covered by this magnet because of its magnetic impact or the magnetic effect, that is called as magnetic field. Clear? And here you can see that this is a bar magnet is kept and in the surrounding you can find out the magnetic lines of forces. Clear? So this magnetic lines of forces or the field lines, if you want to generate, then a very simple experiment can be performed. Okay, just take a cardboard. Okay, just place a white paper on it. Clear? And then a bar magnet should kept in the middle of this one thing and just sprinkle very fine iron fillings on this paper irregularly, unevenly. Clear? Then what to do? Do the next thing. Just taper that cardboard gently. Okay, so this iron fillings will popping up or the jumping up. Okay, and when they comes in the when they become free in the air, then surely they comes in the magnetic field of that magnet which kept there. Okay, so they will also develop a charge and they will also develop a magnetic pole in it, and according to the property of the magnet they will attract and repel each other. And when you allow to settle them, then you just wonder that you will find a specific pattern of the arrangement of this iron fillings around this bar magnet in the same manner. Okay, so you can see that this is the linings which grown around it. Okay, and this is because of the magnetic field around the magnet. Okay, so these lines are considered as the magnetic field lines. Okay, and the tangent to the magnetic field lines at a point gives the direction of the magnetic field at that point. Suppose that if you want to know about the direction of the magnetic field, then on this point, on this one, you have to draw a tangent. Clear? This tangent will give you the direction of the magnetic lines. Okay, and these magnetic lines surely have a path along with a hypothetical free north pole tend to move toward the south pole. Okay, this is the hypothetical. These lines are imaginary, it is not already drawn around this one thing. Clear? But when you allow it to suspend and behave freely, then surely they will arrange in this one thing. You can see that it is starting from north and ended with the south. They are quite denser toward the pole and become somewhat rarer at the center of this one thing. Clear? So this is quite consider the imaginary line, or it is just an hypothetical supposition of the scientist, that is this magnetic lines of forces. Okay, now so here we are going to discuss the characteristic features of the magnetic field lines. So what is it? The direction of the magnetic field lines outside the magnet is always from north pole to south pole of bar magnet and are indicated by an arrow, and inside the magnet the direction of field line is from its south pole to the north pole. Okay, thus magnetic field lines are closed curves. Okay, you can see that from here north to south, and when it come back inside it is from south to north. Okay, here is also north to south and inside it south to north one. Okay, remember this one. Then second one, the strength of magnetic field is expressed by the closeness of the magnetic field lines. Okay, and closer the lines, more will be the strength, than the farther the lines, less will be the magnetic field strength. So this diagram will actually make you very clear that where on the poles you can find out that the magnetic is the strength of the field is very high. Okay, so that's why these are quite dense in nature, while when it moves away from the magnet then they become quite wider in nature, quite more spacious in nature. So it shows that here the magnetic force of the strength of the force will gradually decreases, and here it will increases. So it is more densely occupied at the pole and quite rarer in the center or the middle of the magnet. Clear? Now no two field lines will intersect each other, and if they intersect then at point of intersection the compass needle will show two direction of the magnetic field, which is not possible. Okay, so remember they will never intersect each other, they are always parallel to each other, they always move from north to south. Okay, they are always quite denser and closer to the magnetic pole and quite rarer and somewhat wide space and at the middle of the magnetic substance. Clear? Now so here the magnetic field due to the current carrying conductor, whatever the earlier experiment which performed by the Oersted, it is quite similar to this one thing. Okay, here you can see that we are having the two circuits, circuit A and circuit B. Clear? The only difference is that in the copper wire, when the electric current is flowing, that the difference in the direction of the flow of electric current. Okay, here you can see that the current is flowing from x to y point. Okay, and here you can see that the electric current is passing from y to x direction. Clear? But just give a proper stress on the direction of this compass or the magnetic needle, you can see that they are giving the opposite direction of the magnetic pole here. Okay, so surely this circuit in which a copper wire is placed parallel to a compass needle shows the deflection in needles get reversed when the direction of the current reversed. So hence the electricity and magnetism are related to each other. That means the direction of the electric current will decide the magnetic poles around it. That means surely this this electric current will also have a magnetic field around it. Okay, later on we will discuss that this is called as the electromagnet. Right, now here just to explain about the direction of the magnetic lines of forces we develop around a straight electric conductor. Okay, a law is given that is called as the right hand thumb rule. Okay, a rule is given that is called as the right hand thumb rule. Okay, so it is a convenient way of finding the direction of magnetic field associated with the current carrying conductor. Just hold the straight wire carrying current in your right hand such that the thumb points toward the direction of the current, then your folded fingers around the conductor will show the direction of the magnetic field. Clear? So this right hand thumb rule will give you the direction of the magnetic lines, okay, around a straight conductor. Clear? So with the help of this one thing you can find out this one. So how to do? Just suppose that if you are having a straight conductor, electric conductor, okay, which cap vertically here, okay, so this thumb is showing the direction of electric current which is passes from the lower part to upper part, okay. Then just curl your finger around the wire, okay. So what is the direction? It is the anti-clockwise direction, clear. So this direction of this curling finger around this conductor will give you the direction of the magnetic field or the direction of the magnetic lines around the conductor, okay. So this right hand thumb rule is make you very clear that what will be the direction of the magnetic lines around the electric conductor which is straight in nature. Similarly, suppose that if the direction of the conduct electric current will change, suppose that it is the downward, then what happened? This thumb is showing the direction of the electric current and these fingers are showing the direction of, when you curl around this conductor, then it will give you the direction of the magnetic force or the line of the magnetic force, okay. So this way, that if the direction will change, surely the direction of the magnetic lines will also change, okay. So just for the same one more law is given, that it is also considered the Maxwell's cork screw rule, okay. So according to this one, when if the direction of the forward movement of the screw show the direction of the current, then the direction of the rotation of the screw show the direction of the magnetic field. Suppose that if you are holding this screwdriver in your hand and this is your thumb, okay, and when you are just fixing this screw in a wooden plank, na, then what happened? When you move clockwise, na, okay, then what happened? This screw goes downward in this wooden plank. Then this, the direction of the fixing of this screw will give you the direction of the electric current. Then the direction of your thumb will give you the direction of which thing? That is the magnetic lines, okay. Similarly, if this one surface and when you are fixing this, then this is the direction of which one thing? Moving the this screw, and the direction of electric current, then this thumb which goes in the anti-clockwise direction will give you the direction of the magnetic field, okay. So remember, this right hand thumb rule or this Maxwell's cork screw rule is the same one, and these two laws are given to explain about, to find out the direction of the magnetic field lines, okay, while the electric current is passes through a straight conductor, okay. Now here, this magnetic field due to the current through a straight conductor, okay, just like that in the previous one around the bar magnet, when we develop the magnetic lines or force with the help of the iron filling, similarly around this electric conductor we can also perform one experiment. Just take a cardboard, okay, and just make a central hole in it, okay, and just place this white paper on it, clear, and just pass this conductor through it, okay. Just connect it with the help of this rheostat for the variable resistance, ammeter to know about the strength of the electric current, okay, this source of electricity, a set of battery, plug key, okay, then what, and just place a compass near this one, okay. Just sprinkle again the iron fillings around it, okay, and just plug in the key and just start to tapering the cardboard. So when you taper the cardboard, then this iron fillings will just popping up, and thereafter when they fell down on the surface, na, then they arrange themselves in this specific radius, okay, and they form circle around it, clear. And here you can see that this compass will give you a specific direction of the magnetic field, okay. So here you can see that how this electric current is responsible to develop a magnetic field around it, clear. Now, so if you want to know about again the direction of the magnetic field around it, then you have to apply this right hand thumb rule. You have to just place this your right hand around the conductor, okay, in the direction of the thumb, electric current, thumb, and this curling of finger will give you the direction of the magnetic field lines. Okay, so this is the basic fact, and this magnetic field of the current carrying straight conductor can be shown by this magnetic field lines. Okay, now here this here we are having the next category in which we are discussing about the direction of the magnetic field lines when this electric current passes through a loop. Okay, so what you observe here, we are having again this wooden plank or wooden, or what you say, the hardboard. Okay, we just place a white paper on it, we just make two hole here. Okay, and just make a center line here. Clear? This is the center of this loop. Okay, and just insert this wire, electric conductor of the copper or aluminium, whatever. Okay, and just connect it with the help of this side with the positive terminal. Okay, and this side with the negative terminal. In between, you have to place a the key. Okay, now just do the next thing. Just place a ring, this iron fillings around it. Okay, plug in the key and just again tamper this wood, this hardboard. Okay, this iron filling is popping up and they will arrange themselves in a specific direction here. Okay, here you can see that in the middle there is a straight line. Why? Because the magnetic force from this two will be equal in the center and they will nullify the impact of each other, so you will not found any kind of magnetic induction or the magnetic effect in the center of this two pole. Okay, so here again if you observe that, then what is the direction this side? The electric current is passes from positive terminal to negative terminal. That means here is upward and here is downward. Clear? So if you observe in this downward, na, then you have to place your hand like this. Okay, so what you will observe, this thumb will give you the direction of electric current. Okay, and this curling of your finger will give you the direction of magnetic field lines. So surely this is clockwise. Okay, and if you apply the same with this direction, na, then what you will observe, the direction of the magnetic field is, and this is the anti-clockwise in nature. Okay, so this diagram or this experiment will give you a clear cut information and indication about the relation between the direction of the electric current and the magnetic field lines. Okay, so remember this one thing. Now here we are moving forward to learn about one more term, that is called as the solenoid. Okay, so what is solenoid? A coil of many circular turns of insulated copper wire wrapped closely in the shape of a cylindrical structure is called as the solenoid. Okay, do one thing, nothing special, just take an insulated copper wire, okay, and just wrap it tightly around a vessel. Okay, or you can take a cardboard cylinder, okay, and the bangle holder around it, just wrap up it and just remove this cardboard. Okay, then you will find a hollow structure. Clear? So this is the solenoid. Okay, now just here we are going to discuss about the magnetic field due to a current in a solenoid. Clear? So by just using the right hand thumb rule, okay, we can draw the pattern of the magnetic field which goes around this solenoid. Okay, so here you can see that one end is developed as a north pole and second is developed as the south pole. Okay, and here the field lines inside the solenoid is parallel to each other. Okay, and they imply that the magnetic field inside the solenoid is same at all the points. Okay, just like that, because it is uniform in nature. Okay, while when you observe it outside, then when as the distance will increases in the middle, when you go perpendicular to the solenoid, then the strength will become reduced. Okay, or it is decreasing in nature. So here the strength of the magnetic field produced depends on the two factor. One, that is the number of the turns. Okay, if you will increase the number of the turns around this coil or this wire, na, then it will increase the strength of the magnetic field. And second, the strength of the current in the solenoid is used in making the solenoid. Okay? So by using this battery or by increasing or decreasing the resistance in it, you can control the strength of the electric current which flows through this one thing, will also change the intensity of the magnetic field around the solenoid. Okay, so remember this fact and go through for this one. Clear? Now here we are going to discuss the next thing, that is the electromagnet. Clear? Such a strong magnetic field inside the solenoid can be used to magnetize a magnetic material, for example soft iron. Okay, and when it is placed inside the coil, the magnet so formed, okay, is called the electromagnet. And remember, it is purely temporary in nature. Why we use this term temporary? Because this soft iron is not a magnet, okay, but it is a magnetic substance. It can show the magnetic property only and only in case when it came in contact with the magnetic substance. Clear? So because its permeability and its nature, it will immediately become a magnet. But when you remove the magnetic field, okay, or magnetic substance in from the contact of this soft iron, it will also lose its property, okay, and it will again turn a normal soft iron piece. Okay, so similarly, if this soft iron piece is placed in a solenoid, na, then it will start to behave like a magnet. Clear? And as you remove the as you switch off the electric circuit or the current, then immediately it will lose the magnetic property. So because this magnetic substance shows its magnetic property only in the influence of the electric current, so that's why we call it the electromagnet. Remember, because of electric current only it shows the electric magnetic property, so we call it the electromagnet. Clear? So the magnitude of the magnetic field increases with increasing in the electric current, decreases with decreasing the electric current. So it is directly proportional to the strength of the electric current. Okay? So as in the previous experiments we learn, if you will increase the number of that copper wire turns around the solenoidal structure, then surely it is going to increase the strength of the magnetic field. Okay? And the magnitude of the magnetic field produced by electric current decrease with increase in distance and vice versa. Okay? So as you will move away from the solenoid, then surely there is decrease in the strength of the magnetic field. Okay? Similarly, that means it is directly proportional. Increase in the electric current strength, increase in the magnetic strength. Decrease in the electric strength current, surely decrease in the magnetic field. Okay? Now, so the magnetic field lines are always parallel to each other and no two field lines crosses each other, similar to the normal magnetic lines of forces. They are also behaving the same one. Now, here we are going to discuss about the force on a current carrying conductor in a magnetic field. Clear? So this Andrew Marie Ampere, he suggested that the magnet also exert an equal and opposite force on the current carrying conductor, because you know that already a permanent magnet is having its magnetic field around it. Okay? And when you pass the electric current through a conductor, then this conductor will also behave like a magnet and it will also develop a magnetic field around it. So there is a counter action of the two magnetic field. Clear? So according to the nature of the magnetic substances, either they will repel or they will attract each other. It will depends on the nature of the magnetic field, whether they are similar or opposite. Okay? Now, so here we are conducting an experiment here. Okay? So just set up an experiment with the help of this pipette stand or burette stand. Clear? What to do? Just take a permanent horseshoe shaped magnet, okay, and just place it here. Okay? And then with the help of this stand, just suspend this rod or any conductor, clear, and just connect it with the help of this two terminal or these two wires, okay, one with the positive terminal and second with the negative terminal of the battery, and in between you just place one key in it, clear, okay. Now then what happened, as you will enter this plug in the key, then this current will start to flow this rod which plays where in the magnet. You know that this is the horseshoe magnet, okay. This horseshoe shaped magnet, suppose it having north pole here and south pole here, then according to the nature, what will be the direction of the magnetic line flow from north to south, okay. Remember this one thing. So here is also the current will start, magnetic force line is from north to south, okay. And when the electric current will passes through this conductor, that will also behave like a magnet, and due to this one thing, it will either attract or repel. Suppose in this case, when this direction is the positive terminal is the negative one, okay, then it will attracted by this one. Just do the next one thing, just change the terminal of this battery, then it will responsible for just change the direction of the electric current. Then you will observe that earlier this conductor was attracted, then now in the second case it will be repelled by this one thing, okay. So therefore the direction of the exerted force depends on direction of the electric current as well as the direction of the magnetic field lines, okay. So this experiment is enough to explain you that there is a force which generated by this one, okay. Now here we are going to discuss about the Fleming's left hand rule, okay, which is giving you actually the direction of the motion of that conductor because of the force which generated by this magnetic two opposite magnetic field, clear. So which law? Fleming's left hand rule, okay. So according to this Fleming's left hand rule, you have to take your three fingers of left hand, one that is the thumb, second is the index finger, and third one is the middle finger, okay, and just hold your three fingers perpendicular to each other. You can see that these three are perpendicular to each other, okay. And suppose that if your thumb forefinger is, or the index finger is showing the direction of the magnetic field, okay, this middle finger is showing the direction of the electric current, then your thumb will show the motion of the conductor because of the force which generated by the conductor, magnetic force, okay, which generated by the conductor because of passing of that electric current, clear. So what is the left hand rule of the Fleming? It is just to decide the direction of the motion of the conductor while it plays in a permanent magnetic field and electric current is passes through it. So what is it? Again remember, it is very important from examination point of view. Just hold your three fingers of the left hand, which three one? Thumb, index finger and this middle finger, perpendicular to each other, okay. And if this index finger shows the direction of the magnetic field, this middle finger shows the direction of the electric current, then this thumb will show the direction of the motion of the conductor. Remember this one thing. Now here, just by using this Fleming's left hand rule, here we are going to discuss about the one very common feature, that is the electric motor, which is very important in this modern age, okay. And in every activities like to run your fan, computer disk, okay, your microwave, okay, similarly to pump the water, we are using this electric motor. So what is the electric motor? A device that converts electrical energy to the mechanical energy, okay. It is sort of two type on the basis of the nature of the electric current, either AC or DC, clear. So this electric energy is converted into the mechanical energy, and by using an electric motor, okay, and this motor works on the basis of the rules suggested by the Mary Ampere and the Fleming's left hand rule. So what is the principle of this electric motor? When a rectangular coil is placed in a magnetic field and a current is passed through it, the force acts on the coil and which rotates it continuously, and with the rotation of the coil, the shaft attached to it also rotate, and whatever the pulley or whatever the device which attached with this shaft will use to move accordingly. Okay, so when we want to construct a motor, then we needed an armature. Armature is nothing, it is just a square shape rectangular coil. Okay, one commutator is which one thing? It is a split ring, okay, which is responsible to decide the direction of the electric current. Then the magnet, a pair of permanent strong concave magnet is needed to just develop a magnetic field around it, okay, and a sliding contact or the brushes which is responsible to maintain the direction of electric current, and a battery of course which is a source of electric current, okay. So diagrammatically we can learn this one thing. Here we are having this two permanent magnet with a magnetic pole north and the south, clear. This is the armature ABCD. This is the this rectangular electric coil, clear. Here you can see that this is the axle or the shaft on which this rectangular coil is kept. This is also called as the armature, okay. Here you can see that this split rings are there, which is called as commutator. Remember, this is the difference between the AC and DC motor, okay. In AC motor we are having this commutator as a split ring, and in DC motor it is continuous ring there, okay. And just to keep the constant direction of the electric current, here we are using this two carbon brushes X and Y, okay, which is responsible to maintain the direction, clear. Now here this is the battery, okay, a row of cell is the single key which is responsible to switch on switch off the circuit, clear. So now what happened, as we enter the plug in the key, then as according to the law, no, the electric current will flow from positive to negative terminal, okay. See that what will the path from positive terminal, it goes to the brush X, and from brush X to this commutator, we can call it which one thing, R1. From this R1 it goes to the A to B, B to C, C to D, D to it come to the R2, and through Y it goes to the terminal, negative terminal, okay. So what you will observe, that this is the direction of which one thing, magnetic field, and when this electric current is passes through this one, then according to the Fleming's left hand rule, okay, a force is generated on this rectangular armature, and because it is freely placed on a on an axis, then it will start to rotate, okay. So it will take a half turn, clear. So this time what is the direction from A to B and C to D, clear. When you will take half turn, and suppose that on the place of this commutator there is a connecting complete ring, then what will happen, here is the reverse direction, and it will start to attract this coil, and this coil will stop its motion. So that's why to maintain the continuous flow of the electric current in a specific direction, here we are using this carbon brushes, which is responsible to always maintain the similar direction of the electric current from A to B and C to D. And when this CD will take the next turn, it come to this one, then from D to C, okay, and B to A, then again it will take the next turn, and it will again become A to B and C to D. So this continuous rotation will responsible to rotate it by 360 degree, okay. And this way you observe that this electric motor will work and perform its functions, clear. So you know that what are the uses of this one thing, in the electric fans, to pumping the water, as well as in the different toys and the electric gadgets, which is basically performed by this one thing. Okay, now, so remember the structure of the electric motor, its principle, its functioning and its uses. Clear? Now here, the Michael Faraday, I think so you are familiar with this name. This Michael Faraday gave the law of electromagnetic induction. Okay, so when a conductor is said to move inside a magnetic field, or magnetic field is said to be changing around a conductor, electric current is induced in the conductor. Okay, so what do you observe? If there is continuous change in the magnetic field around a coil, then it will responsible to generate the electric current. Okay, so this is called as the electromagnetic induction. Okay, so here is an experiment is given by the Faraday, and which is quite helpful to learn about the generation of the electric current. Clear? So what to do here? Just take a solenoid structure, okay, and connect it with the help of a galvanometer. Okay, what is the galvanometer? It is a device which used to show the flow of electric current and also to show the direction of the electric current. Okay, so now here you have to take a bar magnet, okay, a strong bar magnet which is having north pole and south pole. Clear? Here you can see that there is no source of electricity, so this galvanometer is just placed in the center of it and giving the zero reading. Clear? Just do the next thing. Move this bar magnet inside the coil. Okay, then what will happen when you move inside this one thing? Then actually you are responsible, this movement is responsible to change the magnetic field around this electric coil. Okay, so this change is responsible to develop a magnetic current because of induction, and it is observed because of change in the direction of this galvanometer. Okay, just remain constant here. You will observe that again that galvanometer will give you the zero reading. Now do the next thing. Again move this magnet in the opposite direction, that means outward. Okay, so this outward movement of this magnet will give you again change in the position of the galvanometer, but now this time in the opposite direction. Okay, so this opposite direction will show you that, okay, the motion of magnet which with respect to coil or vice versa changes the magnetic field, and due to this change in the magnetic field lines, the potential difference is induced in the same coil which set up an induced current in the circuit, and this effect is called as electromagnetic induction. And basically this electromagnetic induction is used to generate the electric current in the generator, or what you call that is the dynamo. Okay, so now to decide the direction of the electric current which generated in it, okay, one more rule is given by the Fleming, and this is called as the right hand rule of the Fleming. Clear? So here what is the new thing? Here the magnetic field and the which one thing, the direction of the motion of the magnetic field, okay, but and the due to this one thing, the generation of the electric current. So do the same one. Just hold your right hand in such a way, your three fingers, that is the thumb, index finger and the middle finger, okay, it stand perpendicular to each other. Okay, so when they arrange perpendicularly to each other, and this index finger shows the direction of magnetic field, this thumb shows the direction of the motion, then this middle finger will give you the direction of the electric current which generated through this one. Okay, so this is the right hand rule of the Fleming. Clear? Here the same place you can see that the thumb is showing the motion of the conductor, this index finger is showing the motion of the magnet, the direction of the magnetic field, then this middle finger will give you the direction of the induced current which generated. Okay, so this all about this session, and remember the rest of the portion, that is the generator and also this thing, difference in the different types of electric current, AC and DC current, okay, and the other circuits and this one thing, this all is now deleted this year because of this specific COVID conditions, okay. So just learn only this much part from this chapter, okay. Just remember about this laws and this one, okay, because it is quite important for your examination point of view, clear. So wish you all the very best, do well and keep studying and keep reading. Thank you.